Welcome to Gyanarthi Vidyalaya online classes. And today I am going to teach you grammar, verbs expressing the present tense. And I am teaching both the sets, the classes 9 and 10 syllabus. So we have to discuss about the tense. Tense three types: present, past, and future. And today I am discussing about the present form, expressing the present, and especially the present simple and present continuous. We shall discuss here, and here two types of verb we shall discuss here. One is be form verb, just like is, am, are, the other one type of verb. Another is have form verb, just like has or have. These are the two types of verbs I am going to discuss. So first of all, I am going to discuss about this is, am, are. These are two types. One is ordinary verb. Another is auxiliary verb. Ordinary verb, just like is, am, are, is used in ordinary without any main verb, just like I am a teacher. Here, am is ordinary verb because there is no extra in which I am. It's okay. But auxiliary verb, just like I am teaching you. Here, main verb is teaching, but I am is auxiliary verb, which helps the main verb, that is an auxiliary verb. So, you know that sentence has different types: positive, negative, interrogative, also imperative, exclamative. But here three types of I am. This is I am, sharp of I am. Negative, I am not, interrogative, am I. First, this auxiliary verb comes first, or this helping verb comes first. In this way, you can say you, or they, or he, she, etc. And you can mix different types of sentences. It's clear? Now let's come to have. Have also ordinary verb and I have auxiliary verb. Just like my father has two cars. Here, which is just it's an ordinary verb, because there is no another form. Yeah? So what auxiliary verb is my father has purchased. Has purchased. Yes, has purchased is the main verb, and has the auxiliary verb mixed with each and made the sentence. So, it is also some type in present form like simple, has, and is singular has, and plural has. Just like different forms, positive, negative, and interrogative. And here we discuss I have, I haven't, I have no negative, interrogative. And I. In this way, present tense form also, you can use different types of subjects like I, like you, like they, like he, she, he, etc. You can make different types of sentences. It's clear? Yes or not? Let's see simple present tense. You have to know in simple present tense, like first person I, we, second person you, third person they. And how do you use these verb forms? Just simple present use plural subjects like we, you, they, also I. Plural subject play. In singular subject plays. And negative, I do not play, we do not play, you do not play, they do not play. Okay? But in singular, he does not play. There is big facts. In question, first, these two and we work out for what? Do I pray? Do we pray? Do you pray? Do we pray? Or similar, does he pray? In this way, we make sentence simple present tense. Clear? Next, you have to know that in which point we can do simple present tense. We discuss first one point to talk things in general. Just like we usually spend our evening on the beach. This is the general talking. Just like the principal always meets the parents between 10 to 11 p.m. Yeah? I teach you English grammar in school time. Yeah? This is the general things I am talking. Okay? Second of all, to express scientific facts. Let us discuss scientific facts. Means that is proved by science that water freezes at 0 degree. Water boils at 100, evaporates at 100 degrees Celsius. Yeah, my father generally. So, it rains heavily in Assam. it's the general fact that happens. What happens, that is also the present simple is used. Now in proverbs, there are many proverbs, all the proverbs also simple present tense is used. Just like too much cooks spoil the food. Yeah, obey your parents. Just like these proverbs, also simple present tense is used. Next one point, natural quality. Just like parents love their children. Yeah, you obey your teachers. The natural quality. Just like a botanist studies plants. Yeah, these are the natural qualities or the professional activities. This type of simple present tense is used. That's our final point. In exclamatory sentence, just like what a beautiful picture it is. Yeah, that is simple present tense is used. There goes the last verbs. There goes the last verbs. That is also exclamatory. Simple present is here. Okay, here comes Sachin, our most promising player. This is also exclamatory, and in this type of sentence also simple present tense is used. Now see the newspaper headlines. Yeah, newspaper headline also simple present tense is used. Just like the Prime Minister inaugurates the annual trade fair. Yes, we can say coronavirus touches 1 lakh, more than 1 lakh. We can say with this type of sentence we can make it newspaper headlines also. So next our point, imperative sentences, also simple present tense is used. Just like go out and lock the gate, bring a glass of water, please sit down, please switch off the lights, please. This type of sentence, march past, all these sentences simple present tense is used. Clear? So next point, future events already planned. Just like I come to teach tomorrow. I use simple present, but if I use tomorrow means that is future, but simple present tense is used here. Yeah, my flight takes off tomorrow morning, but you have to put the tomorrow or the time. That only we can it can be asserted as a future tense. Okay. Number 9 point, conditional clauses. Yeah, if you park the car here, the police will challenge you. Yeah, in this some conditional clause also simple present tense can be used. If you labor hard, you will pass the examination. Yeah, this is one of the condition. If you labor hard, you will pass the examination. This is also condition. Clear? Just like time clauses. As soon as I get the message, I shall pass it on to you. As soon as I get the message, there is a time. Yeah, time clauses. I shall clear my dues when I get my money from home. Yes, when I get money from home, I will pay my dues. Okay, as shall clear my dues, I get my money from home. Get my. This is your simple present tense used. Last point, money commentary. Like any cricket commentary or a television commentary or a school, anybody. We have heard just like, yes, Rohit hits the ball towards the ceiling mid off. The ball passes over the fielder's head and crosses the boundary line. In this way, also simple present tense is used. It's clear? So, continue to study. Yesterday, in present continuous translation, let's discuss. Here, its form is am, are, plus ing form of verb. So, that is present tense. Which is also different types, just like affirmative, negative, 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 interrogative. Just like I am teaching, it should be negative, I am not teaching, interrogative, am I teaching, negative, negative, are I teaching. So you can use either first person I, second person you, third person he, they. So in this way you can make different types of sentence by different person using. It's clear? Let's start with uses. एक्शन गोइंग ऑन नाउ, एक्शन गोइंग ऑन नाउ ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस इज यूज्ड, जस्ट लाइक ए वेरी फाइन ब्रीज इज ब्लोइंग आउटसाइड, दिस एक्शन इज गोइंग ऑन नाउ. यस, व्हाट आर यू डूइंग नाउ ऑल्सो, दिस इज ऑल्सो कंटिन्यूअस फॉर्म. यस, आई एम नाउ टीचिंग यू, दैट इज ऑल्सो कंटिन्यूअस फॉर्म. यस, आई एम फिक्सिंग एवरीथिंग पाइप एक्सेट्रा, दिस कंटिन्यूअस व्हिच इज गोइंग ऑन. सेकंड नंबर पॉइंट, एक्शन गोइंग ऑन दीज डेज, नॉट नेसेसरी एट द मोमेंट ऑफ स्पीकिंग. ओके, सुरुचि इज वर्किंग एज एन एंकर फॉर टीवी स्टार टीवी, दैट मीन्स इन दीज डेज इज गोइंग ऑन एन एज एन एंकर, नॉट मीन दैट इन द पर्टिकुलर दिस टाइम, मीन्स गोइंग ऑन प्रोसेस. ओके, Sushant is preparing for the IIT entrance examination, that also continues in these days, not with a particular fixed time. Okay. Third point, a definite program in the near future. To express a definite program in the near future, he is giving us a trip tomorrow evening. Definite program means tomorrow is going to retreat something item, that is also a definite program in the near future. Just like on Monday, I think for Chennai, there is a definite time on Monday. I am leaving for Chennai, that is center. Though it is present continuous, but it is in future. It is used in present continuous, but for future event. And one more thing we have to know, that in this future event we are using adverb period of future and future, just like tomorrow. Just like I am teaching you extra class, means now, but I am teaching you extra class tomorrow means future event, but I use present continuous tense. There is a difference between using this adverbial of future time, then it's completely something different. It's okay. Let's write here present, simple present, and present continuous. You should know the something differences. You have to know that simple present is the habitual action and states, but present continuous is the action in progress at the time of speaking. Just like I am doing my homework, or I am teaching you. Yes, I am teaching you the action continuing at the time of progress. Okay, but natural habits. Habitual action, just I usually do my homework, I usually teach it, that is my natural habit. Yeah, that's my habit. There's a difference between simple present and present continuous, something different. So you have to know the non-action verbs. There are some action verbs and there are some non-action verbs. In this point, let's discuss here. The first one point we will discuss verbs of senses, a non-action verb, like I see you, non-action verb. I hear you, I taste you, I smell. These are non-action verbs. Now, verbs of feelings, just like I feel, I want, I desire, I like, I dislike, I fear, I love, I have, care, want, yeah, respect, etc. These are all verbs of feelings. Now, verbs of mental states and activity, just like I agree with you, yeah, I disagree with you, I believe, disbelieve, I doubt, I trust with you, I differ, I find, I forget, I imagine, I know, I mean, I recollect, I remember, I think, I suppose, I understand. These are all these verbs of non-action verbs. It's okay, just like the verbs, swine position, I, it belongs to me, yeah, I possess, etc. Number 5, verbs of like seem, appear, it appears to be, it seems to be. Yeah, this is also simple present here and it is not action verbs. So number last point is the verbs like matter, equal, measure, depend, content, etc. Just like we say honey tastes sweet. We don't say honey tasting sweet. Yeah, I want to eat something I want to, not I am wanting to, that is wrong. Yeah, that term is so belongs to, not belonging to. So here all used in simple present tense. जो कि एबिलिटीज का सब होते हैं, एक्शन वर्ब नॉन एक्शन वर्ब। लेट्स कंटिन्यू या लेट्स सी दिस सेंटेंस देन, जस्ट लाइक सी लुक हियर लिसन सी एंड हियर दीज आर ऑल नॉन एक्शन वर्ब्स। लुक एंड लिसन दे आर ऑल एक्शन वर्ब्स, जस्ट लाइक आई सी ए मैन, आई सी ए मैन द नो एक्शन मींस जस्ट इमेजिनेशन। आई after seeing you can see also see, but I am looking at the place, I am looking that person means the direction is going on now. Yeah, that is what non action verb, that is action verb. So you see here, I hear you, that is a non action verb, but I am now listening what you are teaching. Yeah, as your online classes you are listening now, that is or the action verb. But I hear, yeah, suppose I have told many days ago, but he hear, okay, that is the non action. Okay, have also how we use it is in simple present. You don't use in present continuous. I have many books. You don't say I have, I'm having many books. That's wrong. She has a headache. She had okay, and we don't say she is having a headache, that is grammatical wrong. We have to use present simple tense in this form, not present continuous. Excuse me. Now think, this word can be used as action verb, also non action verb. Action verb, just like don't disturb me, please. I am thinking. Suppose I am thinking, that is action verb. You are don't disturb me, I am thinking. Now it is the action. But if I say, I think, this means it is really good. I think, I suppose, it means I suppose. This is not non-action, just imagination. It is in the view, and he speaks like that. Also, you can say many examples. Like, feel. How are you feeling now? Action verb. I feel I should accept this job. That is non-action verb. What are you seeing your doctor? When are you seeing your doctor? Action verb. And I see what you mean. I see what you mean. That is non-action verb. What are you smelling this dish? That is action verb. Does it smell bad? Simple present. That is non-action verb. So you see that in simple present, non-action verb is used, and present continuous tense. What action verb is done? So I hope you. In this chapter, verbs expressing the present tense like present simple and present continuous. I hope you have understood well. So, have a good day, study well. Thank you.